The South Coastal Hockey League.
Here come the Rangers trying to make something happen. Bobby Donahoe comes in, shot, score.
Oh, what a beautiful shot.
The South Shore's premier Masters Hockey League.
Scott Kelly coming up the near side, top of the circle. Goal!
Featuring the legends.
Mike Simon go off to the net. Simon, oh, what a save by Rick Kelly. Net Brinkman gets a break, goes to the net and scores. Jerry, come on, Phantom. Oh, we'll pick it up for the Canadiens. 5:20 to go. Harnish in front. Nice maneuver. Martin scored. 9 for second after tonight is Jim Stone. What a save. Across Antoni. The shot. Oh, Jeff Holstein.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week. Two teams will battle it out for a chance to hold the South Coastal Cup. Game on.
It's South Coastal Hockey this week, the pregame show.
Let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team and their guests for some insight into what's happening this week in the South Shore's Premier Masters Hockey League.
It's South Coastal this week, the pregame show.
Brought to you by Fallon Ambulance. We're driven to care.
Now let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team.
Okay, guys, what's up?
It is the final night of the regular season. And, well, we found out a few things as far as next week's playoffs go in the South Coastal Hockey League. I'm Mark Ducharme, and Director John Kowalski is making sure that I behave in this pregame show. When we get ready for the Red Wings and the Rangers, we'll talk about the playoffs. It is next on the South Coastal Sports Network.
This broadcast of the South Coastal Hockey Game of the Week is brought to you in part by underwriting from Inkstone Printing, Commercial Printers of Brockton, Hospitality Mutual Insurance of Westboro, Fallon Ambulance, Rockland Athletic Supplies, Dr. John Parker of the Parker Chiropractic Offices in Hanover, Panera Bread, the Sunshine Pool Company of Pembroke, Frano & Frano, CPAs of Braintree,
the new Schick Hydro for your skin,
That Bloom in Place, Route 53, Pembroke, by Holly Tree Dental in Hanover, and by Stephen Lee Jewelers of Quincy Square.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week.
As he was heading up, as Rick Kelly and the Sharks celebrating getting into the playoffs after looking like it wasn't going to be for them. As we're underway, play in the Ranger zone. As Harry Matthews battles with Bob Bebo to the near side corner, it's Duggan. Duggan snaps it across. Nobody there is. Jimmy Bailey trying to come in from the blue line and didn't get there in time. Matthews just hikes it out, and Sidoropoulos picks it up. Sidoropoulos for Tom Smith. Smith trying to go wide, gets it around Bailey, dumping it deep. As grabbed by Mike Everson. Rangers trying to get the first shot on Rick Welsh. They will not. Here come the Red Wings back on the breakout feed. It's Teddy Duggan on the right side. Teddy Duggan coming in. Backhands it in front. And however, Harry Matthews got tied up by Bob Sidoropoulos at the last moment. And cleared out by Jim Hutchinson, center ice. Kevin Brophy, the Red Wings captain, dumps it in. Brophy, as the Red Wings change up, Sidoropoulos back for the Rangers. Bob Sidoropoulos on the right for Tom Smith. Smith snaps one in, and Rick Welsh grabs it and ties it up. And he's just waiting for a whistle, and he's told, no, no, play it, play it. First shot of the game to the Rangers. As Mike Crisp couldn't get the puck. Red Wings trying to come back as Burke couldn't get it. Crisp takes it away, flips it back into the Red Wings zone. Mike Mullen and the Wings try to come up the ice, however knocked down by Joe O'Connell. As here come the Red Wings trying to work it back. Burke for Brophy. Brophy curls around. As Kevin Brophy and the Wings start up the ice and flip it in. Steve Quinn tries to get it out. Grabbed by Mike Mullen. Shot goes wide of the net. Only had one shot so far, and that's to the Rangers. Brophy from the blue line. Save. Doc Smith. Rebound. Grab. Snapped across. And it goes off Jeff Hoover's skate. As Kevin Barnard snapped it off the skate of Jeff Hoover. 1-0 the Red Wings. So Kevin Barnard for the Wings. Two minutes into the game, Kevin Brophy will draw the assist, and the Wings are on top. as the Wings trying to break it back. They've won all three meetings between the two. The Wings in the playoffs already. They're trying to get the third spot if they can. Pat Burke sends it in and goes right in front of the net. Over. They chased it, and actually you can't, you know, it was Kevin Barnard who fired the shot and put it off Jeff Uva's skate and into the net. Barnard should get the goal.
We'll change that.
Yep, Rick Kelly joining me, but the Wings, that'd be a sigh of relief. You come into the rink, okay, we're getting ready, we have to win. Then all of a sudden you look at the scores coming into the rink, guess what? You're in the playoffs. The Canadiens still can't beat the Leafs on a consistent basis. They get that one win and then bam. Gilderson up the near side. Figlioli broken up in the play. Sidiropoulos starts back. Sidiropoulos has been hitting on all cylinders here in the second part of this fall season. Trying to jam it in on Rick Welsh and had it knocked away. Steve Perkins sends it around and out of the zone. Uva curls back for the Rangers. Uva knocked down by Figlioli. DeCecca. Ron DeCecca swept away by Jeff Uva. Ron DeCecca is, this is the team that he just doesn't score against. It's the funniest part of the whole thing.
Got some great moves, Mark. That move just then just barely broke him up, but he's real quick with his hands. There he is right now.
Fired wide. DeCecca only had a goal against the Rangers last year. He's got two this year in the three meetings. It's Pat Burke who owns the Rangers. He's got five goals against them.
Well, Doc said the kind of season, too, his own people, off his own teammates skate, so it's he said the kind of season, this, unfortunately, this year.
Well, the Rangers, yeah, they, well, I mean, Billy Hinchey still has the best line for the Rangers this year. Yeah, the future Crusaders do look good.
Yeah.
And they've been playing very well at the stretch.
Here we go.
Duggan back, lost control. Uh-oh. And Bobby Donahoe had the stick wrapped on Teddy Duggan. I think Bobby Donahoe is going off Rich Manning with the call. He and Jeremy Convis are our officials. 8:01 to go first period. 1-0 Red Wings and the Sharks back in the playoffs. Oh, by the way, congratulations.
Yeah, we finally get back in it. Team had a lot of spirit tonight that usually lacks a lot of times, that team. But they changing up every 45 seconds. Really very, very intense. The team definitely wanted it more than the Whalers did. And of course, the Whalers are reigning champions, too.
Well, you get the Stingers next week.
Well, that's a challenge in itself. They beat us 3-2 last time we played them. We played a good game against them. So if we play the way we did tonight, we'll win. If we don't, well, then it's a different story.
Uh-oh.
It's an intensity.
It's going to be on the locker room wall.
That's right.
Red Wings
play your game.
Red Wing power play. We get the Saints and Toros, by the way, next week in our matchup for the playoffs. This one we're trying to find out in the classics. Leafs are the one seed. Blackhawks are in the 2-3 game no matter what. But who they play, it's either the Wings or the Bruins. And the Bruins and the Blackhawks are playing as we speak.
I know I get promoted tonight. I don't get my regular photography job, Mark. So.
Well, I mean, you know, we figure you got about 62 pictures on the Sharks that will be on the page.
162.
Red Wings haven't done anything on this power play.
Did he get shot on net?
Yeah, they I don't think they've gotten in the zone. Matthews will try once again.
What do you think, Mark? They know they're in it. It's kind of like, we're skating boys. It doesn't really matter, you know?
But who would you rather play, the Maple Leafs or the Blackhawks?
There you go.
And that's what the telltale is. As far as everything goes. Because on the Red Wings, I'd rather have a shot at playing the Blackhawks. No offense. The Leafs have been the best team in the classics in the second half.
I think this guy is concerned about who's going to play with Andrew Pelliot with a season-ending injury. What would happen now? The way the rules work, you have to use one of the goalies that is not playing and get eliminated. So it'd be, you know, Doc Smith, obviously, if you wanted to do it. Because they can't use Denny Farrow. Now, Denny Farrow will be their goalie next season. He's been playing for them the last 3 weeks. He doesn't qualify for the playoffs.
Uh-oh, there goes his share.
Yeah.
Playoff share gone.
That's it. Money's gone. Here we go.
Burke. Save Doc Smith. Whoa. We get a souvenir. I mean, the Rangers were firing pucks at us before the game, and now Doc Smith's trying to get us.
Do I get a save for that?
Yeah. You finally got a save. Goals against average tonight is 1,000 for Rick Kelly.
Thank you.
Bob Sidiropoulos and the Rangers are leaving up as Kevin Barnard, who got the goal, wins the faceoff. Jeff Uva squeezing it up off the boards, kept in. Nope, it wasn't kept in as Bailey tried to keep it in, but the Red Wings clear out. As it's center ice, it's Bailey. 5:30 to go, first period.
Well, the fun really begins next week, Mark, with the playoffs.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, everybody was totally confused where things were all going tonight.
Well, the wackiest thing is if the Stingers go out and beat the Toros tonight, it is the puck is ice. The Toros will go in 1-6 as far as the playoffs go. They'll limp in. That win last week was the one that clinched it for.
Wow.
It is the weirdest thing.
I think the website was burned up this week. People trying to figure out what was going to go on because there's so many ifs and ands. And
I thought it was the shoot the puck because it was trying to see if you and Billy were going to be in the movie for shoot the puck. Everson?
That could be interesting. On YouTube, presented by South Coastal Hockey.
Yeah.
We devour any knowledge of shootthepuck.com or any control of that. Whoa!
Smith off the Pat Brecker opportunity. You know, Pat's making, he's going to be making Joe proud. What a season he's having.
Yeah, 3 years ago, he was just a middle-of-the-road player. He's a good player, but he didn't stick out. And all of a sudden, the guy's scoring leaps and bounds.
Well, this is the team he scores against. Of the 8 goals he's got, 5 are against the Rangers. It's amazing.
He wants to play him every week.
And Ron DeCecca, who you would associate with high scoring, Ron DeCecca doesn't, you know, this is the team when now his teammates are shooting at him, and DeCecca got mad and turned around and rifled one.
Just missed. Doc had that far post covered, but it was close.
Figgioli?
There's like legends out there all behind the net, going for the puck. Legends are might see 225-pound guys playing might see hockey. I'm sorry, 240.
Well, we were saying, you know, it's been quicker games, but you guys just said one of the quickest games of the season.
We were changing up. I was screaming. 45-second shifts, and the Whalers had, they were short bench tonight, so I figured they have, obviously, the league MVP goaltender, too, but he didn't have a good night tonight.
They struggled. They, like the Toros, in the second half of the season, I think they were 1-1 game in the second half of the season. It just, everybody... Those two teams, the Toros and the Whalers, just the thing was that the Whalers just kept on, didn't have the cushion that the Toros had. The Toros had a hell of a cushion.
And those of you who want to see our new rosters, there are minimal changes in the rosters for next season. I think there are like 4 new players total.
Wow.
And those won't be up until the season is over, so you won't see those until after the finals, the week after next.
You mean you're spoiling Sawtell's Christmas?
Ooh, there we go. Michael Mullen gets to spend a little time sitting
Michael
down.
Michael Mullen will go off as he just crushed one of the Rangers. Power play for the Rangers coming up with 3:29 to go, opening period with Rick Kelly and Mark Sharp. South Coastal Hockey League game of the week.
Mike, I can see now. I got my new eyes. I can see the far end of the ice now.
Yeah, but
I had to guess in the past, you know.
But you're looking down to Oliveira's, for God's sakes, from here.
Yeah, well, Joyce is good. Joyce has got a buffet for us down there tonight, Mark. Yeah. Free food, that's your favorite line, isn't it?
Wow.
Sorry, free.
Wow. Wow. And the Rangers get the goal at the faceoff. Wow.
That was ugly. That was ugly, ugly goal. I'm as ugly as I get.
Tied at 1 on the power play for the Rangers.
John Grabowski bought his Tupperware. He's going to take some home food home with us. Be a single guy, you know, we got to take care of it.
Well, you've got a box in the crate.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah, but you got a box in a crate.
I look vicariously through John Grabowski.
Paul LaFond, the unassisted goal.
He's my hero.
But I mean, I was amazed that you got an ice chest and another ice chest in the car.
Snow shovel. Ooh. Nice move by Donald.
Bebo doesn't hang on to the pass as Duggan ends up with the puck. And a 1-1 game, Rangers and Red Wings. Bebo ducks down, Duggan ends up with the puck, slides it out, Perkins in from the blue line, save rebound, laid there almost at the feet of Doc Smith, but he caught it as he was going down and tied it up.
The smartest way to do it. You try to hit it off your blocker so it falls in your glove, otherwise you keep your body in front of it, just fall right down with it. Biggest thing, you go down too quick, ends up going over your shoulder. His timing on that was great.
2:41 to go here in the opening period. Rangers trying to break out. They tie it up on a Paul LaFond goal after Kevin Barnard scored for the Red Wings. It hasn't been the two prettiest goals. LaFond trying to go near side, and Welsh got a piece of it. That was the Barnard goal was shot out a range of defenseman skate. Jeff Hoover. He's dug in on the breakaway. What a feed. Dug in! No! What a play by Bebo, but Harry Matthews just hustled in and finished it.
Blame that on the defense. Tuck didn't know where it was, but it wasn't in the net. And nobody's reacting around him. They should be talking to him, yelling to him. Be behind you. Put your pad out. He could have spread his pad straight across. No one talked to him.
2-1 Red Wings. Harry Matthews the goal after Teddy Duggan gets stopped on the breakaway. Perkins started the whole play with a pass up the side. Is in front, Sidiropoulos tried to roof one with a backhand to the far side and missed. Shoveled out, and here come the Wings and a 2-1 lead. Pat Burke rolls up the ice, pushes it in on Doc Smith, grabs it, knocks it down. Quinn tries to clear it out as it's Farley slowing it down. Barnard shot off the backboards. Jeff Uva picks it up. And Jeff Uva just couldn't. Oh. Well, now he finally gets it out. Got a little help, and Joe O'Connell pushes ahead with 1:25 to go in the period. And the Red Wings on top. Burke, Everson company just not really cleanly handling the puck.
Those of you watching live, Mark will give you the lineups for the playoffs for next week before we go off the air.
Yes, I will.
So,
we did it in the pregame. We did it in the pregame. We just need the Bruins Blackhawks result. Then we can officially give the whole situation.
If not, folks, you can go to SouthCoastal.com.
Evanson cranked it off the crossbar.
That was sweet, huh?
Boy, he has got a wicked shot. All the Wings, the defending Classics champs, got themselves into the playoffs before this one began. We'll say it again. It made life a little easier for them. And they're playing free and easy right now. They're controlling this opening period. Rangers were playing very well. They were doing the spoiler roll.
Oh, here we go.
As Burke. Oh, Gillison and Piggioli. They're going to say Piggioli was ahead of the play. Richie Manning made the call right away.
He was. When you're a goaltender, you love to hear that whistle. Guys ready to wind up and crank one at you. It's like.
Doc Smith was like, yeah, I know. We'll see how the whistle's being blown. He's looking back at you. Who's saying that?
Well, Mark, it's fun to be back. Like a promoter for the night. Promoter for my photography job.
Oh, I mean, you know.
And my post-game interview job.
Well, Bob Hayner wanted to make sure. That was his Christmas present to you.
Thank you. Do I get his pay, too? I get the bonus. Yeah.
We haven't heard anything. Isn't Hayner on...
Zero
times 100
is still zero.
That's right.
Isn't Hayner, you know... CIA mission or something tonight?
He gets his South Coastal pension, too. So.
To Saskatchewan? LaFon.
Moose.
Just had a shot
Moose
blocked.
Jaw. He's in Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan.
Well, the period's going to come to an end. Paul LaFon got the Rangers goal. Red Wings get goals from Kevin Barofi and Harry Matthews. After one, it is the Wings 2, the Rangers 1 on the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week. Paul LaFont got the Rangers goal on a power play, and Rick Kelly's still back in gear doing those shots at night. He and Bob Hayner can have a, I think they might have a discussion during the playoffs about who has the best in keeping shots on goal. I haven't figured that out yet.
Well, I'm very liberal, and Bob lets, he's not, the goal union, you know, we count everything. Shots towards the net, shots hit the boards behind the net, you know, we have to.
Like a soccer goalie. Yeah, I can always remember.
Sartell.
Whoa! What a feat, Sartell to Jay Parker. And Parker looked like he was going to get his first goal. And Rick Welsh is like, yeah, baby, I got it.
Beautiful play.
That was a well-run play.
That was a highlight film play, yeah. Tell Jim Smith, highlight film.
So when did Sartell get that ability? And the Red Wings come back, and Steve Piggioli beats Doc Smith near side. Boy, you talk about a turnaround in a hurry. The save by Rick Welsh down here at one end. And Steve Piggioli comes back the other end and backs it home. 3-1 Wings.
Doc just flinched that one right over his glove. Someone's that close to you, I try to make yourself as big as you can because you can't move that fast.
Bailey and the checker get the assist. Now the Wings have headed their way with the Rangers. In the three wins, it's been 5-2, 5-1, and 4-3. And the Wings just keep on doing it to the Rangers as Matthews couldn't knock down the attempt by Perkins towards the net. He couldn't reach a rack. Funny thing is the Rangers are probably playing their best right now. One scratch for them tonight is Jimmy O'Toole.
It is a huge scratch. It's a monumental scratch.
Bailey, blue line, shot deflected behind the net, feed in front. Matthews tries to get it. Dugging again for Matthews. Well, we have one good scratch as far as the Wings go is Mark Tedeschi.
Rangers will have at least two new players on the roster next season beginning January 6th.
Is one of the people leaving Mr. Sartell? Is this his last night in a Ranger uniform?
No, Mr. Sartell is returning on paper. Here we go, Sidoropoulos.
Sidoropoulos! Blocker save by Rick Welsh.
Great save.
Well, you know, I mean, all we see, you know, the shootthepuck.com movie is that, you know, he's hunting down those Legends teams right now.
He's staying where he is for now.
Oh, Bebo shot gets deflected off the side of the net. Tommy Smith grabs it.
Ruffles all alone.
Perkins is peeking at him. The one thing, the Red Wings defensive core might be one of the better, well, more underrated ones. When they're there, Brophy, Perkins,
Jimmy Bailey,
Mike Evanson.
Yeah, got a big reach.
Evanson's got fat, great wheels.
That looked uncomfortable.
Varley sends it around the board. It's Captain Smith. That's what I mean. Evanson, by night. Nice little slap of the puck out of the zone. It almost got it around Quinn to create an opportunity, but was knocked down by the Rangers, who will start back. Jeff Uva carries it in. And the offsides, Richie Manning with the call. 8:58 to go, middle period, 3-1 Red Wings. We will give you, instead of a scoreboard update, this is how the playoffs look as we speak. Next week, 7:50, Stinger Sharks in a Legends Division matchup. 8:30, the Leafs could be playing either this Red Wings team or the Bruins. 9 o'clock, our game of the week, the Toros and the Saints in a Legends matchup. Blackhawks. Well, either the Bruins or the Red Wings, as far as their matchup goes. The last game of the night, Legends Division Final the following week, as is the Classics. And the Classics, believe me, we don't know what to expect. These could be one of some of the greatest playoffs. That is a shot out of play. The Stingers going for their first ever title and will go in as the one seed for the first time.
And they'll tell you, they are nervous. I was talking to their team captain yesterday, and he's like, We're not counting anything.
You threatened them to send them to Saskatchewan, for God's sakes.
Moose Jaw. Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan.
Tony Shaw's in Florida going, will he make the trek up here for that?
It's a 1968 yellow school bus with no heat.
Tony Shaw will be driving it, coming back. He wants to come back, and you know he wants some cold weather just to come back.
Hear from Tony all the time. I'm sure he's watching tonight live. How you doing, Tony?
Hey, Tony, how you doing? Well, figure, you know, Tony's probably got the shark doll out right now, voodoo, you know, putting pins in it.
They have them?
I don't know. Oh. Maybe he went over to Louisiana for it or something.
If we could make money for it, I'd get them.
Kelly
dolls, that's right. The Kelly doll was sticking the number one shark doll. People sticking pins in his head.
The Checker?
Comes in a wheelchair.
The Checker?
And a walker.
We want to thank Ron the Checker for letting Rick Kelly with the following promo announcement.
That's right.
Ron the Checker's held the puck for the last 15 seconds and finally shot and tied up.
Hey, Ron, there's people with a white shirt other than you.
Well, Ron was just practicing his moves around the net. He was putting on it. It's the Tom Emanski school of puck handling. Yeah. I mean, he was like,
well, he's good at it.
He is good at it. If you had Fred McGriff, no problem. Fred McGriff was like, wrong sport. Crime Dog, it was a great nickname. Perkins fires it. Mingioli can't jam in the rebound. Doc Smith grabs it, ties it up.
It's only second shot on net in this period. Not a lot of shots on net. That great blocker save by Rick Welsh off of Sideropoulos was the five bell save of this period.
That was Jay Parker. It was the Sautel to Parker pass.
Oh, that was off the pads. Rick Welsh with the blocker save, yeah.
But, you know, the goalie union, he remembers all these things.
That's right.
Doc Smith almost. And a guy down the other end was getting ready to crank up the goal light.
We had a meeting earlier on, about six, seven goalies all standing around talking. And Sautel went by and made a few remarks, you can imagine. Break them up. Too many goalies in the same place. Break them up. We're going to get out the whole of shop, Stewart, our union. We're going to get back at him. We need more of those T-shirts they used to give out for the goalie union we had.
Because not a client, he's the president of that union.
Only in his mind.
Yes.
Here we go.
As the Rangers try to get going. Sideropoulos right into Rick Welch's pads, and on the rebound, Bebo trying to jam it in.
One thing
about the Ranger defense, they go to the net very well.
I'll tell you, Sideropoulos didn't have a lot of room left. I thought it was going to be wide. And he's also a left-hand shot to get that. It was a pretty good shot. He fired the last possible second. Rick Welch could have stood up thinking it was going to be wide.
You know, one of the Rangers is his brother. Is Bob's brother coming up to play with him? That would be scary if those two were back together again.
That could happen.
Those two would be phenomenal together.
It's not out of the question.
Bebo, shot deflected. Brophy got a piece of it. Sautel.
Sautel on the
butt. Sautel tries to jam it in front. Philly's probably discussing everything with him. You know, I have a player move that's right up your guy's alley.
I'll tell you one thing about Billy. He knows this game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
He knows this game so well.
And I say it for one other reason. Duggan coming in on the break. Because you look at the teams, and you look at how they're constructed. And this is not suck up. You look at the balance as far as winning titles go. It is insane. Piperbrink tries to curl and lost the puck out of the zone and brought it back in. But, I mean, he has different styles of teams, which is amazing to me.
Yep. Got a couple more guys there tonight watching, trying to get in. I said, sorry, guys. Talk to you this summer.
Yeah. Well, we were saying possibly in your division, the best team right now isn't even playing in the playoffs. Crusaders.
Yeah, they're really good. Well, Bob Stafford's made a huge difference because he's really got it back. And as you know, he used to play in our senior division. And for the Wolves, he's one of the best goalies there was. He put in some shows.
Well, they won four of the last five. Win tonight, they get a 3-2 win over the Saints.
They're only one game out. They won just one
more
game.
Mike Simon got the winning goal in that one. Smith couldn't handle the pass from Hutchinson. Your game, Richard Petrosino, two goals. Sharks 5-0 win. In the Classics, Marty DeCourcy got three, and the Leafs win over the Canadiens.
Rangers out shooting the Red Wings 5-2 this period so far.
It's not a dominant five, you know, dominant. It is just like, oh, we got a shot. Oh, okay. Harry Matthews has got a goal. Bad pass. Smith fires it off the pads of Piperbrink. Harry Matthews.
Penalty.
Yeah, he got hooked from behind by Tom Smith. Tom Smith just got a piece of him, and Tom Smith gets his third penalty of this fall season.
Argument there.
Second Red Wings power play. They did very little, if anything, the first time around. Rangers had their one power play and scored. Kevin Barnard. It always seems in games of the week, Kevin Barnard he's become the new version for the Red Wings. Barnard snaps it off and has it blocked, but I mean, Barnard in games of the week always seemingly gets at least one or two points in a game. As Barnard had a couple of shots, but Pettum both blocked. Hoover carrying it down. Jeff doing a good job and just killing off time.
Oh, great defensive move by this the Red Wings. Red Wings are really smothering them when they come down the ice, aren't they?
Yeah, but look at this. Mike Evanson, we could have a 4-on-2.
This guy's got a great shot.
Evanson gets tied up in the play. Sideropoulos used his speed to slow down Evanson. Evanson just squeezes it back out. Barnard from the blue line. Shot the fucking in. Is it Pat Burke that got it? Or was it Mike Evanson who got it? It's either Burke or Evanson who got it. But it was snapped in from the blue line by Kevin Barnard. And Burke is saying, yeah, okay. Richie Manning says, okay, you got it. Okay, I'll give it to you.
That's good. I thought Scott Marley tipped it on the way in, too. So.
But the Barnard shot was perfect. It was long the ice.
Bailey.
No.
It was on the ice. 10 got the goal. 11 wasn't on the ice.
Oh, by the way, Wings win this. Wings, by the way, win this one. And they have a 4-1 lead. They play the Blackhawks next week. Blackhawks shut out the Bruins 4-0.
Oh. Shut out the Bruins.
4-0.
This is their first line?
Look at this.
Look at that.
It's wow. Empty on
wow.
That side.
That's unheard of against those guys. Those guys are a scoring machine, that first line.
Johnny Dunn had a goal and an assist in that game. So, right now, the Blackhawks and the Red Wings could be a matchup. The Bruins and the Maple Leafs, wow. That might be the best semifinal matchup, the Bruins and the Maple Leafs. Sidiropoulos.
I think so.
Oh, you think that, how would you like to be Jim Stone and whoever the goalie is for the Leafs that night? Because you know you're going to see a lot of shots at you. The Wings and the Blackhawks are going to be very close, tight checking.
I hope it's Denny Farrell, but we'll see. It can be Doc if he wants it.
Well, the Rangers trying to change that. And say, wow. Whoa, Rick Welsh got a piece of that one off the glove. LaPon picks up the rebound. This Mike Crisp got a good
Mike
shot
Crisp,
off.
Nice shot off. I'll tell you, that was going for the top corner.
Gilderson. John Gilderson carries it in. As LaPon will get the puck that was squeezed in front and trying to create the other way. Mike Mullen slows it down, flips it back in. 2:20 to go, middle period. Red Wings have 4 different goal scorers, and they lead 4-1.
Quick game, Mark. Not a lot of whistles.
Oh, speed game, I think Red Wings favor. Grinder, I like the Rangers.
Yeah.
Uva, Mullen sweep checks it away. Pipe and Brink gets it up. Duggan cut off by Hutchinson.
Ison?
Yep. Nope. Waved off. I was going to say either that or else Hutchinson could have been called for interference because he just put the arm, he put an arm bar out.
Yeah, I saw it, referee.
Rich Manning.
Richie Manning raised his hand.
Wing, Sautel.
A pass back to Sautel. It's like Larry Bird passing it.
To Kevin McHale.
To
Kevin McHale. They said the black hole. You don't get it back. You don't get it back. Jimmy Bailey rolls it in. Wings by the way.
Billy sees the ice though.
Oh, he does.
He just knows this game so well.
We kid Billy, but Billy does do a lot of good things on the ice.
But he knows the game, yeah.
He doesn't have the speed that he once had. Oh, it'll be the Parker. Parker going to knock it in. Sautel shot. Save, Welsh.
Two fabulous saves by Rick Welsh in a row.
Billy will probably have Rick Welsh traded after that one.
Rick Welsh has had 3 or 4 highlight film saves tonight.
Yeah. Well, whoa, down the far side boards. Harry Matthews has been run over a few times by members of the Rangers.
Bobby Beagle, Jay Parker.
Yeah. Sidiropoulos slowed down. Mike Evanson slowing him down. Mike Evanson, Bob Sidiropoulos looks back at Richie Manning. He says, I didn't, you know, he didn't hold me. Burke back. Pat Burke looks. Pat Burke measures. Shot save. Burke on the rebound. Doc Smith, another save. Pat Burke trying to set up a third opportunity. And Barnard will get the deflection as it's rolled towards the net. Burke using his reach. Varley trying to squeeze one through and shot it wide. As the final seconds of this period wind down. As Rick Welsh making a couple of good saves in this period. And goals for Steve Figlioli and Pat Burke. Red Wings could be the third seed in the Classics division if they hold on with this 4-1 lead after 2.
Rakeli here. Welcome back to Hoppawalk Arena in Pembroke, Massachusetts for a game Red Wings and Rangers, our last regular season game between the teams here at Shots on Net, a net period. Rangers 8, Red Wings 8 for a two-period shots on net. Rangers 14, Red Wings 17. So pretty close. We've had some real highlight saves by Rick Welsh and Doc Smith have both played a good game. Not a lot of softies out there, Mark.
No.
But
the only call softy was the Lafond power play goal. And after Rick Welsh in the first period. That's the Ranger goal. Red Wings, Kevin Barnard, Harry Matthews on a rebound, Steve Piccioli on a rush up the ice, and Pat Burke in a play in front of tipping one in off the shot by Kevin Barnard, who's got a goal in.
Pat Burke again.
Pat Burke has owned the Rangers. His seventh goal against the Rangers in four games. He has got Pat Burke 10 overall. 70% of his goal scoring is against the Rangers.
I counted it, Mark. There were five Red Wings passes. It went to five players before the fire went in the net.
Varley and Barnard the assist. Barnard a three-point night. And the Red Wings appear on their way to being the third seed and getting ready to play the Blackhawks in the first round. And the Leafs will get the Bruins.
It was like they were in the penalty. Bang, bang, bang. Five Red Wings touched that puck before it finally went in the net.
This is the Wings are starting to slowly build.
When you're a goaltender, you react to each pass. Every time you have to move over and over, you have to totally. It's like playing pool. You're just waiting for the next thing, which way it's going to go from there. You have to move five times.
You know, funny thing is, you know who right now is the worst goals against differential going into the playoffs? The two teams, I mean, the classics that have the worst goals against differential will be the Blackhawks and the Red Wings if this stays the way it is. Wow. Because the Red Wings will have an 8+8, and the Blackhawks have a +7. And the Legends, you know who's got the worst differential going into the playoffs?
Toros.
Sharks.
Really?
You've got a +3. Toros, depending. No, yeah, you're right on the Toros. Depending on what the Toros do tonight. The Toros are -3. And you know, Paul Brinkman's going to blame Kenny Mankella for that one.
Well, I'll tell you that. They probably have the best first line of the Legends. They don't always seem to put the points up, but they're probably the most skilled ones.
They'll be playing the Saints. That'll be our game next week in the playoffs. Be the Christmas special. Rick Kelly will be singing Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer between periods.
I will. I'm going to sing the national anthem, too. No, I'm not.
No, but you should be doing Rudolph.
We'll make sure. We'll talk to the production team about the music and make sure there's some Christmas music.
Yes.
Production next week.
Figgioli.
Just the fact the Sharks have to play one more week is a present enough.
Well, which member of Sidiropoulos for Chris? And he misses the net. He tried to go upstairs with it. By the way, which one of the Sharks sat on Santa's lap to get that your wish?
We started the season awful. Came back and played quite well the last few weeks. Thought we'd get to win two more games before it means anything, right?
That's right. Singers. The check. Can't get it redirected on the net. 9:35 left. Red Wings complete control of this one.
They know it, too. I don't see the intensity that they saw the first period out of the Red Wings right now.
No.
Face it 5-1 with 9:25 left to go.
Oh, they know they're in good shape.
You got it.
And Richie Manning is not in good shape.
Oh,
Jerry Converse. Poor Jared. I mean, Jerry Converse.
Put up the blue line. They do that with the Legends a lot.
Well, he just wanted to practice. He wanted to see. He says, yeah, I can do that, too. Evanson. Void Sidiropoulos. Those two are having some good battles in this one-on-one battles. Matthews knocked loose. Brophy will grab it. Kevin Brophy. Duggan, tip pass, trying to get it to Matthews. Went by him. Bebo picks it up.
Neutral zone trap. They're just trying to kill time right now.
Oh, what? They're playing the clock. There's nobody else that they're playing. The Red Wings are in great shape. Evanson. They and the Blackhawks will be on paper, it should be a 2-1 type game.
We'll put it in perspective, this period is now a third over, one shot on Doc Smith.
And Doc Smith just saw the second opportunity go whistling by him.
Welsh is Having a nice cold drink, but he didn't see nothing.
No, Rick Welsh is just like sitting back. Do I have you? I don't have to do much.
That's the way you like it. Keep your team in it.
You know,
shut him out. All you have to do is keep your team in position.
Well, he made a couple of big saves in the second period. Perkins runs it down low. I mean, that's all he's got to do right now. He's played all the wings doing last 740 plus. That's all they're trying to do is get rid of that and squeeze it off the clock. Duggan dumps it in. Burke, who's got two goals in this game.
Look at fans, you can go to southcoastal.com anytime. See our current standings. See all the last games of the week are there on the website. You can actually watch all the games that have happened the last couple of years. And all the stats. Keep track of everything that's going. South Coast Hockey League at southcoastal.com.
LaFongue trying to break it out for Sautel. Sautel got a good shot in the middle period from the slot that was knocked down by Rick Welsh. Scott Varley for Pat Burke. Burke didn't really go hard after because all he wanted to do was just tip it ahead and kill some more time off the clock. Quinn for the Rangers. The Rangers just haven't had the best of times. They played well down the stretch, but tonight they are just not able to slow down the Red Wings. The Red Wings all of a sudden have been the Rangers' nemesis. Last year was the Rangers who won the season series, but the Red Wings had the biggest win of all in the finals last spring. A 6-4 win over the Rangers in the championship game. The Red Wings, who hadn't been in the playoffs in 6 years.
Wow.
6 years. 06 to 2012, spring of 2012. First trip, and they win the whole thing.
Back in the old days, Mark, when we first started, they win consistently, the champions.
They won six, and now that was the seventh. They lead the Classics. They are the leader in the Classics. They're 7-1 in the finals right now. They're the money team in the finals. And it was some of those years that you didn't think that they had a chance.
Well, this period's half over. One shot on net, Red Wings on Doc Smith.
Oh,
this guy, you said right, Arthur's trying to kill it.
Play
on the clock.
Well, as soon as Pat Burke got the second goal, 33 seconds in, they're just making sure. Fagioli.
Nice pass.
Steve drops it off. The checker. Saps one in, block Doc Smith, rebound. Gilderson and Fagioli canceled each other out, getting the rebound.
I saved Doc Smith, goes pads down.
Rangers squeeze it out, center ice, Brophy turns around. Brophy off the boards to Cheka with 5:33 left. Red Wings broke this one open in the second period, scoring twice, about 4-1, and added one here in the third.
Whoa.
Oh, Mike Evanson, hello, good move, and Jeff Uva was draped all over him, and Evanson still got the shot off, and Uva's patting him on the head and laughing.
Uva was skating on the edge of impropriety there, almost got himself a penalty, but.
This might be the fastest Classics game we have ever had.
Yeah,
fastest game, period. Looking at the.
Yeah.
Time on the wall. I mean,
42 minutes into the hour.
Yeah. Bobby Donahoe back for the Rangers.
Let it go, Bob.
Bobby Donahoe gets the first shot of the period for the Rangers with 5:05 left in the third period.
He was a legend. That shot would have been wide, right?
Or out of play. Take your choice.
Well, during the moment, the guys holding the boards up on each side of the net for me. They missed me.
Okay, he's loose. Yep, okay. He's moved from side to side. 4:55 left.
Barry only had a couple of good saves tonight because they didn't get a lot of shots on. The Sharks are very dominant.
The Whalers are not the most potent offensive team, the Legends. Bebo shot through the pack. Welsh to save. Welsh ties it up. 4:46 left. If the playoffs were to begin right now, Legends, Stingers, and Sharks one side of the Legends, Toros and Saints the other. And the Classics, Leafs and Bruins, Blackhawks and Red Wings would be the other. That would be how the matchups would go. But we still have 4:40 left.
Back pass
Rick Welsh, nice stop. Cleared away on the rebound by Jimmy Bailey for Harry Matthews. Matthews couldn't control it. Bailey. Pipe and blank. Snaps it towards the net. Perkins knocked it down in front. Stop back. Steve Perkins. A little too harsh of a pass for Teddy Duggan to handle. Bebo just trying to go over through the net with it.
Doesn't work usually very well.
He tried to roll it up over.
It's not a good idea. If you're going in the back, goes in the net.
I mean, Doc Smith was not looking for that one. Harry Matthews. Matthews will get a rebound goal in this one. Bebo bothering him. Matthews, loose puck. Matthews is like, it's tied up. Nope, it's rolling around. Harry was kind of surprised by that one when it rolled at his feet.
Oh!
Get by Mike Mullen. Can Mike Crisp get to the puck first? Rangers changing up. 3:30 left. Rangers goal was Paul LaFond on the power play. Red Wings. Pat Burke has got two. Kevin Barnard and Harry Matthews and Steve Figgioli have the other goals. Barnard, 3-point night. As Kevin Barnard will end up being second on the team in scoring to Pat Burke. As far as total points go, 17.
Fans at home, we have 2 weeks of playoffs beginning next week. Mark will give you the lineup in the post-game show tonight. We'll see you so the next 2 weeks. Then the next season starts January 6th, right after that.
Do we have a horseshoe or something? Because it's 2013 is the year.
Doesn't the world end Friday or something?
Oh, well, we heard that back in the millennium back in 2000.
Right, we're going then too. Yeah.
Yeah. 2:43 left. Duck in the scores. Blackhawks 4-0 over the Bruins. As John Dunn, a goal and assist. Leafs get 3 goals from Marty DeCourcy. 5-3 win over the Canadiens. And just, boy, the Maple Leafs are the Grinch that steals Christmas from the Canadiens. They did it again. Canadiens get their first win over the Leafs in 33 games. Then right after that, the Leafs said, you know, that was our Christmas present. We let you win once.
No more.
No, we'll kill you for the next two.
Varley.
Varley is just, Varley's just killing time. Scott Varley knows that this one's in the bank. As Evanson snaps one off, Doc Smith to save. Legends tonight, Crusaders 3-2 win over the Saints. Mike Simon, the game winner. Richard Petrosino gets 2 goals. Barry Kaiser gets the shutout. Sharks 5, Whalers nothing. Sharks knock the Whalers out of the playoffs and get in themselves. As Rick said, we'll give you the playoff matchups. We get 2 minutes and 10 seconds of game time before we do that. Evanson, the checker! Oh, ooh, what a nifty little attempt.
That was not a good one. That would have been sweet.
The checker trying to do it.
Talk a good lateral move on that. He might have had it, but it was a good move.
Jay Parker coming back. Parker had a couple of good opportunities for Paul LaFond in the pass by him. Gilderson off the boards. The Wings have done what they've needed to do. Build the lead and just cruise. They get the Blackhawks next week. I don't know, without looking up who did what against what. I'm the Red Wings. I'd rather play the Blackhawks because the Leafs have been playing unbelievable since about the midpoint.
They have. And even with a different goaltender, they have been very, very well. And,
Leafs average, by the way, Rick, 4 goals a game.
Well, I'd be odds on favor to carry the cup, that's for sure.
64 goals in 16 games.
A scoring machine, no doubt.
And it's a bunch of people.
With Denny Furrow in that, next season they're going to be something to deal with because he's done very, very well for them, too. Oh, Andrew wasn't a good goaltender, but Furrow is good, if not better.
Oh. I know. You poor Andy. You gave him those pads. Ever since he got those pads, it's like a bad omen for him.
Yeah. He got that surgery, that's it. Yeah, we'll miss him. He's with us a long time.
Those snow castles have been so...
He was famous for that.
Yeah, he was great. 55 seconds to go in the game.
Loved his helmet with the snowman on it.
Oh, he loved it. And he played it perfectly. He loved it. And he had other teams going. My best Andy story ever was we named him player of the game once. And I saw him over at the West Coast game. And he walks up to me and says, I wasn't the best player in the game tonight. And he starts, tries, and he goes, I go, then who was it? And he says, but I wasn't the best player. I'm not the best player tonight. I didn't deserve the player of the game.
You deserve that. You want it because you get the free raise, you get the friendly's gift certificate, you get a garden center certificate, you get lunch at Uno's. It's worth it. You ought to be. You want the free stuff, Mark. You know?
Well, Andy, you know, but this is before the friendly's trip and on sofa.
Oh, okay.
That was before. That was last year. I always remember that. By the way, Justin Mattinson, DJ Mattinson, Corey McGregor are just giving you all those pictures out there. They've done a great job in making sure that we are under control. In the final 10 seconds of the regular season for us, then we get to the playoffs.
An 8-man crew to do this. Mm-hmm. Between the timekeepers, goal judges, 3 camera people.
How does Hammer count in this? Does he count as a half? Chick Hydro post-game show is on right now. And, well, the clean shave of the night as far as the Red Wings go was just a total team effort. Wings win this one 5-1, clinch third place in the Classics division and draw the Blackhawks instead of the Maple Leafs, who are probably the hottest team in the Classics. Leafs will play the Bruins, which is no picnic.
No.
No. Can you? Okay, the good news is we're the top seed. The bad news is we're playing the team that could be the top seed.
Right.
That's all there is to it. With Rick Kelly and Director John Grabowski and Mark Deschamps. In the Legends, Stingers, and Sharks, one matchup. Toros, Saints, the other matchup. Well, before we get into those, story of the night, I mean, the Wings just rolled and rolled and rolled, and they weren't going to in when they needed to, and just put the puck in the net.
Here's the Pat Burke Show.
Yep. He's got two.
That's what he said.
And Kevin Barnard's got a goal, too.
He loves playing the Rangers. He should trade teams every week. He could play the Rangers every single week. He'd be the team's leading score. No doubt about it. It was kind of a dominant game, so outstanding goaltending on both sides. Rick Welsh had some super highlight to film ones. And all the goals scored on Doc Smith, except for one, I think, were A-quality.
Yep.
5 bells, but a lot in front, a lot of deflections. I have to admit, the Red Wings were all over them. The third period, just kind of laid back a little bit and just kill the clock and
sure.
Get into the playoffs.
And the Red Wings are in the playoffs. Now the playoffs begin next week. And if you were going to name player of the game in this one, Chick Hydro player of the game, it's either Barnard or Burke. It's either
right.
One.
Yep.
Those are the two that just dominated. Playoff time.
Let's have it, Mark. What are we doing?
Legends. Stingers Sharks. That's the first game of the night. 7:50 matchup, Stingers and Sharks. Stingers are the top seed, best record overall in both divisions, and right now, as Artie was telling me before, they're leading the Toros right now. They could be 13-1-2 coming in.
Wow.
Best goals against differential because they'll be over the Leafs, who had a 20+20. For goals against,
yeah,
Mark Frano's ridiculously low
goals against. Yeah, he's under 2.
Yeah, yeah. Mark Frano, who's got 4 shutouts this fall, and he has been on fire. And the Stingers, but the thing is, the Stingers were the best scoring team in the Legends, which is, I can't ever remember saying that one.
No, it's never happened before. No. That team was slowly getting better. They were always missing the players, missed places off. They were getting first-round draft picks over and over and over again. Mm-hmm. Well, finally, that team is pretty well stocked, and that's why the results you're getting right now.
And they worked it.
And Mark Frano's in the zone right now, and that'll help a lot, too.
Toros and Saints, the other matchup. The Toros and the Saints, that ought to be... Those two teams just have good matchups.
It's at 9 o'clock. That'll be
the game of the
week.
The Toros and the Saints always have good matchups. It's up and down the ice. It seems like whoever comes up with the big plays... In those games, that's all it is. It's just, it's who's on that night, which member of the Toros, is it Brinkman, is it Ward, is it Holmes, comes up big, or is it for the Saints, is it Todd Roach, is it Jimmy Callahan and Jimmy McNeil? Who comes up big in those games, seemingly wins those games?
I'll tell you, it's real intense. All these teams want it very badly. No team like, hey, we're already at the playoffs, we're always here.
Mm-hmm.
These guys want it bad.
Yeah.
These guys are intense. I think the Stingers aren't going to sleep for a week right now getting ready for that game. They want it so bad.
Well, you put the bulletin board material up for them.
That's right. We'll give it to them.
Leafs, Bruins, Classics Division. That is going to be a fire, you know, firearms versus each other.
That'll be a 6-4 game or something. You know,
yeah,
or
those will be
7-5 game. You watch, yeah.
I mean, the Bruins, for gosh sakes, have the 1-3-5 scorers in the Classics. The Leafs have Marty DeCourcy, who finished with 20 regular season goals in 16 games. He had 3 tonight. Marty DeCourcy. It's going to be Marty DeCourcy. And quietly, this guy's like Mike Bartlett in the top. This Jeff Gauthier. I mean, I'm just looking at the classics. They had 64 goals. The Bruins had 54. They were the third best scoring team. The Canadiens were the second best scoring team. The Canadiens are watching as far as it goes. And the reason the Canadiens are watching, they gave up 59.
That'll do it.
That'll do it. Blackhawks and Red Wings, that could be the – that actually is the two best defensive teams in the classics. They'll hack at each other. 37 goals allowed by the Blackhawks for the season in 16 games. Red Wings allowed 44.
So, Mark, what do you think? All high-scoring games in the classics?
Every time we say
low of the legends, yeah.
Yeah. Every time we say it's going to be close, yeah. And high, it's the opposite. I had that run for like 3 weeks where I couldn't. I kept on hitting it. Bob Hainer kept telling me that I kept saying it right. That's ended. Yeah. It's ended. Back to normal.
Shots on net tonight. The Red Wings at 22. The Rangers 18. So not a lot of shots on net tonight, even though they scored 5 goals on those 22 shots.
No, the funny thing is that the Red Wings had very few shots from the perimeter. Very few.
They were touching the puck for, like, one goal, I remember, they touched the puck 5 times. So they were passing over. Everybody wanted to be Adam Oates tonight. They were passing, 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 passing. But then again, they get the results. You get the goalie moving back and forth lateral 4 or 5 times. Sooner or later, he's got a gap there. And a lot of traffic in front. They played really well.
The Red Wings had 19 goals in the 4 games against the Rangers. That tells you the Red Wings, they're in the playoffs because they might be wishing, could we play the Rangers again?
Yeah.
Could we play the – and especially Pat Burke, who gets 7 of his 10 goals for the regular season against the Rangers.
Oh, Pat Burke's the only Red Wing in the top 10, right? So
yeah.
You go, yeah.
And after that, you got to find Scott Farley down there. Oh, Scott's 12, down there.
12 or 13. So Pat Burke's in the top 10. Because why? Because the Rangers. That's why he's in the top 10. But, hey, good for him.
I mean, the Canadiens have a lot of people. I tell you, everybody tells you that it's scoring, scoring, scoring. The Canadiens in the top 20 have 6 people in the top 20. They're watching, which is surprising.
Anybody wants to get our news blast every Monday at noontime, you get a news blast from the South Coastal Hockey League. Go out to you, show you the pictures from tonight's games and also all the inside dope, what's going on. At southcoastal.com, you'll see in the left-hand column all the standings, all the playoffs will be there, and all the matchups, and it'll be a lot of fun. So follow us, and you'll see us here again next week.
Okay, Legends Division playoffs again. Our game will be the Toros and Saints on the game of the week. Stingers and Shark are the other side of the bracket. In the Classics, the two sides of the bracket. One side will have the Leafs and the Bruins. The other side, Blackhawks and Red Wings. And it playoffs begin next week. And then the finals the following week. And that's a New Year's special coming up for you on the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week. Well, Justin Mattinson, DJ Mattinson, Corey McGregor provided the pictures. John Grabowski made sure that we behaved ourselves somewhat.
He's got a leash on me.
Well, I don't want him to call my stocking again from Santa.
That's right.
Yeah, so for Rick Kelly, I'm Mark Deshawn. Red Wings found out they were in the playoffs before the game, then they made it the best of it. They're the third seed after they beat the Rangers tonight 5-1. For everybody at the South Coastal Hockey League, good night. You've been watching the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week. Anxious, he just went flying through the puck. Oh, Michael Ireland, nice save. It's in at the back line. Rick Welch in there. Barnard comes in. Barnard, nice feed in for what a save by Holstein, but it rolled over his hand and in. Tater's answer. Michael Hanks and Dana Dolan, Baney, or check it, Tim Cruz.
Didn't miss by much either.
No, Harnish in front. Nice maneuver. Martin scores.